Well, my name is Micayla Gatto. I'm 25 years old. I've been riding mountain bikes in general, since I was 12, so that's 13 years now. My math is correct. I started off with cross country and road, and then when I was about 16, I realized that I actually enjoyed the downhill portion of the cross country racing, and was lucky enough to get a downhill bike for my birthday, and kind of took off from there. I would say expressive and passionate, probably. To the outside world, maybe. And I feel like that's the image, I guess, I portray. Funny and crazy. Oh, maybe that's my one word, creative. It's not a very creative explanation, but the most misunderstood thing about me is that although I come across as being this crazy, funny, exuberant, expressive, creative person, I actually am very driven, very focused, and very serious about what I do in my life and my passions. Like, I'm an artist, sure, I'm creative, I like to play music, I race mountain bikes too, and wanted to do sort of street art style on used skate decks. And also because I'm broke and I can't afford to buy canvases and I can't afford to buy wood panel from art stores. So one of my cousins had an old skate deck and he was like, here, just you can have this. And I'm like, all right. So then I scraped it all down and repainted it. And that was the first one. That
awesome.
Skeleton Una Vida, this guy.
Okay.
Was my first one. So this one was just for like a... It was for school, and it was like a CD case. She's just upset. She's turning into a skeleton, and she's not very happy about that.
Yeah.
This is supposed to be Andrea Lukangi. I don't really think it looks that much like him. Hashtag of the senses. This is for Clay Porter, for the 3-minute gaps.
Yep.
So you might, if you've ever seen the movie, you might have seen this kind of flashing up on the screen for the S4P compound. It actually brings me so much joy to just the process of drawing, just sitting here and moving my pencil around and creating something that I'm happy with is like such a satisfying feeling. It's the same feeling, it's a way mellower feeling, but it's essentially the same feeling I get when I go for a really good ride or do anything that you're passionate about. Biggest struggle as an athlete. Being able to, I mean, I don't want to say it all comes down to money, but essentially being able to support myself and my goals and dreams without taking up too much time so that I'm able to train and concentrate on my racing. Pretty hard for me to see my boyfriend, who's a professional Olympic athlete or Olympic hopeful, with full government funding and support, that he's able to just concentrate on being a professional snowboarder. He does everything he can to be the best that he can be. And that's what I want to do, but unfortunately I don't have the funding, so I have to work 8 hours and then I get to come home, eat something quickly, run out the door, go to my other job, go to the gym, and it's just physically, mentally, like, time constraints, everything, it's impossible for me to put in as much work as he's putting in. Like, it's hard work, and I think athletes are some of the most determined and hardest working people out there. And then we get rewarded with amazing sponsors, being able to race around the world, things like that. You're essentially a billboard for those companies that you love and trust and represent, and you want to portray the best parts of yourself and the best parts of your life to the public. But a lot of the things that also kind of misconstrues the public's idea of being a professional athlete and what actually goes on in our lives. So my mom is a huge help. I mean, we're sitting in her basement suite, essentially. So she helps me out so much. My boyfriend helps me out immensely. The trainers at the gym are kind enough to volunteer their time to me. They see the potential in me and they really want me to succeed. And same with everyone in my life who helps me. It's like they kind of see my dream and they believe in it as well, which encourages me and motivates me. But at the same time, with all their support, I can't help but feel like indebted to them. Yeah, it's like they're giving me all this stuff to be successful. So if I'm not successful, I feel like I've robbed them, you know?
How heavily does that weigh on you?
Pretty heavily.
Yeah.
Like the first. I feel like I've got a good head on my shoulders and that I can take things. Like, I am very detail-oriented and I think I get that through my art and my creativity. But at the same time, if something doesn't go perfectly, I'm not the type of person to freak out or be in a bad mood all day because I had to eat a different type of cereal. Like there's some people out there that are very, 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 very regimented and stiff in their whole kind of perspective of life and what is supposed to happen and how it's supposed to happen. When I was 10, I was essentially given 24 hours to live. At the time, I didn't know because I was really, really sick, but I got a bone infection and I had to live in the hospital for over a month, and as a 10-year-old, it's pretty traumatizing, and I also feel very lucky that it happened to me because, number one, I'm okay. They found out what I had and I didn't die, so that was good. And number two, it just gave me such a huge perspective on life as a whole. Like most 10-year-olds in American and Canadian society, middle class, you're invincible. You feel like nothing can touch you, and then suddenly one day you're swimming with your friends and the next week you're lying in a hospital bed hallucinating and given, you know, that could be it. Like, doctors don't know what you have and obviously the situation is really severe, and it kind of just made me realize that life is so precious. And it's like life, although I have like these huge passions and drives, life is so much more than not everything going your way. It's like, it's okay. Like, I'm just so happy just to be alive and to be able to do things like follow my dreams and my passions. And I feel like that experience really kind of made me who I am.
Unfortunately, I think in any sport, it's not all just skill set. You need a tremendous skill in order to do what she's doing, or any sport really, but you also need, in order to be competitive, you need what the other people have. You know, money's not an issue, and they get the best coaches, they get the best equipment, they've got a huge entourage behind them. That helps. In the so-called off-season, well, they move to a warmer climate, they keep training, you know, everything's great. Having watched her through her seasons, and at the end of every season, she seems quite frazzled. The stress of competing, knowing that now she has to sort of buckle down on something else to make money to compete the next year. I think you find that quite stressful. Yeah. So, you know, yeah, just kick back for a bit.
What makes Micayla different than anyone else on tour? That would definitely have to be the amount of talent she has. She is pretty much talented in anything she does. So for someone to be able to have that natural ability just to do whatever, pick it up and progress and continue to improve on themselves, it's pretty amazing. And I think given the right opportunities, not only will she pick those up and utilize and be able to embrace and grow from them, but she'll hopefully, potentially do really, really, really well from it as well.
Just the actual act of riding my bike makes me so incredibly happy. But I feel so lucky to be able to, for the most part, follow my passions and follow my dreams. even if I do have to work my butt off to try and pay for it, and some days are really tough and it is a struggle, but I wouldn't trade it for the world, because those moments of success or like getting on the World Cup podium makes everything I do worthwhile.
Would be #GattoBooty, definitely.